Hello and welcome back to the NSC here in the Isle of Man for an evening of great excitement. Warming up behind us now is the Isle of Man men's team alongside the Guernsey men's side, and they're going to take on each other at 7:30. They have met before now during COVID when we had a pathway between the islands, so they're regrouping and re-meeting again. Anita Navin will be with us throughout with the live commentary, and she'll be with us shortly with the lineup.
Experience an island like no other. The Isle of Man, the extraordinary story. Book now.
Well, welcome to the Isle of Man and a very special event, the first of the Invitational Island Netball matches.
Playing against teams of this standard is something we don't get to do very often, being from an island community, and even watching some of the matches that's going to be coming up this week is going to be an amazing experience.
It's the first time that we've been involved in anything of the scale as well. Just the exposure for all our players is really good.
We've got 15 players with us, and we have youth and experience. We're hoping to use everybody throughout the week.
We've had a look at some of the teams. We know the Isle of Man are 27th in the ranking at the moment, so know that they're going to be quite a tough team. Jersey and Guernsey have been a setter for quite a while now, and Orkney and Shetland as well are teams that we're looking to compete against.
Everyone says it's all fun and games, but you kind of want it to be serious. You want to go out.
We'll be going for it for this week. We want to go out on top. Everyone has usually played everyone at some point and seen everyone at some point. That hasn't happened this time round, so there is a lot of unknown.
There's a much bigger picture at play here, and it's about not just representing your island but representing netball at this competition and in the Island Games. And I think going forward that's something that we all share, a common goal.
It's a great feeling playing for Orkney, and we've not really done anything outside of Scotland, and all we really have is our inter-county match against Shetland every year and the Scottish Cup that we enter.
I think for us it's just seeing what we've done, have we prepared in the way that we should prepare?
Yep.
Or do we need to go back and reflect and see where we need to go for there?
We've hosted a few competitions like this now, but the nerves are still there and we still want to do well for a home crowd. So although we're experienced, we still get the same adrenaline. And that's what this makes this competition quite exciting. It's nice to play new opponents and it's nice to play people that haven't played us before. So we're really looking forward to it. This has been all over social media. There's been a lot of excitement around it, and I think netball fans on the island are looking forward to this as well.
Probably just like to take a moment just to thank the Isle of Man Netball really for taking a leap of faith and backing the teams, backing the game and getting ourselves in a position where we can run something like this.
So a warm welcome to the final game on day four of this competition. We're thrilled to see the Isle of Man men come up against Guernsey men in what I'm sure will be a fantastic game to end day four. So taking a break from the Island Invitational Netball Games, and we are about to see the Isle of Man men come up against Guernsey men. So a fantastic opportunity for the crowd. We've got the players in, excited to see this game. So our umpires for this game, Fiona Kemp, Bailey Mitchell and reserve umpire Marie Skillicorn. A big shout out once again to our technical officials, just getting themselves ready to be announced and brought onto court. We can see in the picture the Manx Rams, who've just played the game previously against Orkney, taking a win 64 goals to 25. We can see them there just about to watch their men play in this match against Guernsey. So the Isle of Man men play Guernsey today and there'll be a rematch again tomorrow at 11. So there you can see 9 a.m. in the morning, Inismon versus Guernsey. 11 a.m. Guernsey men versus the Isle of Man men. 1 p.m. Shetland versus Orkney, and at 3 o'clock Jersey versus the Isle of Man. So, as we welcome then the Isle of Man men onto court, Michael Josem, goal shooter, Jason Philbin, goal attack, Michael Pardo, wing attack, Robert Mason, centre, Peter Corrin, wing defence, Stephen Mulhern, goal defence, James O'Neill, goalkeeper. The interchange bench, Jake Hicks, Torren Jones and Stephen Ronan, coach Claire Batty. And for Guernsey, goal shooter Luke Foden, goal attack James Robert, wing attack Mark Barnett, centre Carl Abbotts, wing defence Lev Kerken, goal defence Luke Penny, and goalkeeper Tristan Quiripel. The coach Jill Quiripel, and the interchange bench for Guernsey, Dan Bitton, Tim Priddis, George Simmons, Tom Nifton and Jason Roger. So the Isle of Man will start this match, the final one on day four. Early contact call there on Quiripel, the goalkeeper. And the Isle of Man get the first goal on the board. So O'Neill looks for the options. Then again on the support. So Philbin on the rotation, super long shot by Philbin for the Isle of Man. Pardo looks to get that ball in to Philbin. Oh, great hands again by Quiripel, the keeper for Guernsey. Too much on that. So tipped again, throw in Isle of Man. Josem pops another goal in for the Isle of Man. Through to Robert. First goal on the board for Guernsey. Fake pass there from Mason, secures another goal. Great vision, deception there from Mason, the centre, who steals the ball back from Barnett at wing attack. Yeah. Josem Holstrong for the Isle of Man. So possession back with Guernsey. Chance now for James Robert. We'll get the penalty. Isle of Man 4, Guernsey 2. Mason over the top finds Pilvin. Good vision by Mason at centre for the Isle of Man. Robert not able to put that ball in, will get another chance on the penalty. And secures a goal. Three goals in for Guernsey, five to the Isle of Man, and it's Mason, the Isle of Man centre. Picks up the ball intended for Josem, but he gets it back and will get the penalty. Vodan asks for the ball short, steps in, too much on that one, gets the rebound. Oh, super shot there from James Roberts, the goal attack for Guernsey. Excellent pressure from O'Neill, James O'Neill, the goalkeeper. Both shooters on the goal line. Ball gets through to Pilbin, who puts the ball in. 6-4, the Isle of Man lead. Their centre pass as Mason offloads. Elects to go backwards. Gives the shooters chance to reset. Super ball in. And that was into the hands of James Pilbin. Robert working the ball, wanting to get closer to the post. Too much on that shot. So, another chance, not able to convert Guernsey. Possession with the Isle of Man. Brilliant. Again, super shooting. Great transition through the court by the Isle of Man. Get the ball on the straight line, the direct route. Players just getting themselves ball side. So one to watch. That's the work of Jason Philbin, the goal attack for the Isle of Man. Showing excellent court craft so far and putting the ball away from the mid-range. Mason forced back to the transverse line. The Isle of Man reset to the hands of Philbin once again. So Guernsey just chipping away at this lead as they try with Quarapel to stop that run of Philbin. Pull back on the penalty as Philbin looks for Josem. Steps in and into the hands of Quarapel. Great rebound. So Guernsey on the transition, going short. Great split there from the goal attack, James Robert. Good hands from the goal defence. Mulhern for the Isle of Man. Go. Great shot from James Robert. Another goal on the board for the Isle of Man. Michael Pardo, the wing attack, supporting Philbin really well on the shooter side. So another chance for the Isle of Man as they hold a 4-goal lead on Guernsey just into the final 3 minutes of this first quarter. Barnett caught up the court. Great shooting action and goal scored by James Robert. And off the post, Guernsey not able to get that ball to a shooting opportunity. So Isle of Man transition again through the court. Pardo elects to cross the ball. Some solid defence around the circle edge from Carl Abbotts. The centre for Guernsey. 8 to the Isle of Man, approaching the final minute of this, the first quarter. Patient build-up from the Isle of Man, playing short, not afraid to put the ball back and reset at the transverse line. Horripel tries to put pressure on the feed. So again, it's Philbin, the pressure point, and he gets the ball under the post. So throw in Guernsey, 20 seconds, time to move the ball down. That's an intercept there. Robert Mason, the centre for the Isle of Man, regains possession. There we go, that's the end of the first quarter. 12 goals to the Isle of Man men, 8 to Guernsey men. So a well contested first quarter. We'll take a few minutes break and we'll be back shortly for the second quarter. welcome back for the second quarter as Guernsey will take us off on the centre pass into this next 15 minutes. Just one change for the Isle of Man men. We see Peter Corrin, the wing defence, go to the bench and he is replaced by Stephen Ronan. So it's a 4-goal lead for the Isle of Man as they go into their patient build-up again. Impressed with the way they navigate their way through the pressure of the midcourt. Just taking that extra pass so to not put pressure into the attack and the shooters. So Mason with the throw-in. Transition through the court by Guernsey, straight line play, and that's the work of Vaudin, just not able to secure that goal into the hands of James Roberts, just caught on the contact. Philbin will get the penalty. Offloads to Josem. Great contest, good pressure put on that long ball into the shooters. That was James Arneil from the Isle of Man. Luke Vaudin just not able to secure that ball there. Good pressure on the front by James Arneil. Contact call comes. The contest was there. That was the goal defence from Guernsey, Luke Penny. And he gained the call there from the umpire. So, chance for Vaudin. Put the ball in. Settles. Deep breath. Puts that ball in. Settles for the shot. Better play from Guernsey. Just taking the pace off the ball as it moves itself towards the shooting third. So Guernsey regained possession. It's a good contest down in the circle now. Stepped up the pressure. That's the work of Quirrell and Penny for Guernsey. Up against Josem and Philbin. Good support play on the edge by Barnett there. So Kayakan has moved to wing attack for Guernsey. That news just coming to us from the officials. And we see and we've confirmed Ronan on the wing defence for the Isle of Man. Tom Nifton, he enters the game at wing defence for Guernsey. So it's a tighter game. Guernsey adjusted, made some changes, checked out where the key players are for the Isle of Man, certainly putting more pressure on the ball that was getting through to the goal attack for the Isle of Man, Jason Philbin. Credit to Guernsey, found their form and coming back strong with a great goal there from James Roberts. Tied game, 13 goals each, Guernsey in possession. Robert steps in, another great goal, takes the lead. Guernsey for the first time, 14 goals, please. Isle of Man, 13. Ball goes against the Isle of Man again. It's really stepped up the pressure. That's the work of Quarrypel and Penny, the two circle defence from Guernsey. Just an injury time called there. So there will be a change, and Joe Quarrypel just preparing that change. So well contested game so far as we just wait for that change to be made. Guernsey making a great comeback in this second quarter. Super goal again by James Robert. The pressure, fast feet of the defence, just moving around the bodies of the two shooters, Josem and Philbin from the Isle of Man. But Philbin settles the ship a little bit for the Isle of Man, getting that goal. Guernsey still lead by one. Stronghold there by Michael Josem secures the goal. So back to a tight game. 15 goals, Isle of Man, 15, Guernsey. So possession back with Guernsey. Tom Nifton looks to play the ball through. Good pressure in the midcourt. That's the wing attack again, disrupting play from the Isle of Man, Pardo. So giving the Isle of Man possession. But Luke Penny, goal defence, taking over. So up and down in terms of possession. Lindsay, just need to reset, just provide a couple of options forwards, not force that ball straight through to goal. So Quiripel looks to offload. Guernsey work their way through the mid-court pressure. Tim Pridis enters the game at goal shooter for Guernsey. Ball unfortunate there, gives the Isle of Man possession, so a chance for the Isle of Man to take this ball through to goal, still trailing by the one goal. Oh, attempted the feint there, and Joe's then just not able to pull that ball in. So just 3 goals scored by the Isle of Man in this quarter and 8 to Guernsey. So we can see there the comeback that they've made as they will get the throw in. So into the final 3 minutes of this, the second quarter. Robert. And possession just given back to the Isle of Man with contact call. Great work, Pardo. Uses the 1-2 from the transverse line, linking well with Nifton. So a key shooter, James Robert, takes a step in, sets for the shot, just not able to secure on that attempt. And James O'Neill, again, possession lost by the Isle of Man. So a little bit of tidying up to do at half time. Reset, just need to be patient, sight the options early, so turning fully to face down court will certainly help the players as they transition out of defence. So Robert settles the ship, scores another goal for Guernsey. 17 goals to Guernsey, 15 to the Isle of Man into the final minute. Robert again uses the out and in at the split landing and is successful. It's been a good quarter for James Robert, the goal attack from Guernsey. Philbin keeps the ball in play and scores. So a two-goal margin as Guernsey will need to take this ball quickly through to goal as we approach the 10-second mark. Great long ball, but just not able to get there into the hands of Tim Priddis. So there goes the buzzer. That's the end of the second quarter. The shift in scoreline. Guernsey taking the lead, 18 goals to the Isle of Man, 16. So an exciting second quarter, a real turnaround. Guernsey really found their form, scoring more goals and really getting themselves in tune through the court in their play. So we'll let the players take a break, the coaches reset, and we'll be back shortly for quarter three. So welcome back, and the Isle of Man kickstart this third quarter. So just to bring you the Isle of Man changes. Corin goes to wing defence. Hicks goes to centre. Mason to wing attack. Pardo goal attack. And Philpin goal shooter. Just getting caught on the contact. Quite a bit of contact from behind on players. So it's just a matter of moving the feet, just trying to get around the front. Oh, great shooting from the Guernsey goal attack. Chance for the Isle of Man. Philbin back at goal shooter. Again, just getting caught behind the Guernsey defence. Really solid structure by the defensive line of Guernsey. Quiripel gets the throw in, gets the reward. Forced back. Guernsey, that's the work of Abbott. And again, just a loss of possession. Back with Guernsey. Robert tries to work his way in. Robert not able to convert on that occasion. Quiripel gets possession. Guernsey go again, supported on the transverse by Quiripel. Just that long ball then read by the goal defence, Mulhern from the Isle of Man. Thank you. stepped in, not able to convert. Just an out of court there, so Guernsey back in possession. Long ball finds Robert. Foden again down, so just a timeout called. So Guernsey with the lead as the Isle of Man again transition through. So 4-goal margin in favour of Guernsey. Better swing of the ball across the circle there as the Isle of Man look it to goal. But that's a footwork call against Pardo. Long ball through the middle finds Robert. Guernsey just forced to reset. Better play, great cut towards ball side by Robert. So not without chances, the Isle of Man, it's just a matter of getting that ball safely through the line of defence of Quiripel and Penny. So just a little bit more movement helpful for the Isle of Man shooters. So Philbin on the front takes the shot, secures. So, a 3-goal margin, Guernsey with the pass. There from Robert and Bowden in the backspace. Great vision there from the attacking line of Guernsey, and that's the work of Erkan. Guernsey lose the possession, chance for the Isle of Man. Good work, good support play from the transverse line, and that's the work of Corrin at wing defence supporting as Philbin looks to go across the circle, gets the ball back. Pick up there by the Guernsey centre, Carl Abbott. Robert. Again, great shooting. 5-goal, the margin between Guernsey and the Isle of Man as Guernsey go again with their centre pass. Robert with the fake commits the defender, Pardo, sorry, and that is the work of James Robert. Excellent shooting on the goal attack. So O'Neill and Mulhern for the Isle of Man doing all they can, but it's Robert that is really dominating in the Guernsey attacking circle. Isle of Man just not able to retain possession. So Guernsey looking strong when they bring the ball through into their attacking third, particularly with the shooting strength of Robert as he holds the front position and goes again. Great shooting. So the last changes for the Isle of Man, O'Neill at goal shooter, Corbin goal attack, Ronan wing attack, Mason at centre and Hicks at goalkeeper. So the Isle of Man making significant positional changes through this game, searching for that combination that could add a little bit more pressure onto Guernsey. Get a sense that the shooters from the Isle of Man need to take those shots in the mid-range as they try and get the ball closer. Sure, that's the message that will come at them from the bench. So Robert again with the penalty. Good defensive pressure from the back there and the work of Hicks from the Isle of Man. Post moving, Philbin will get another go. Oh, super elevation there from Quarrypel. Philbin offloads to O'Neill. Oh, checked by Quarrypel. Excellent transition going long there, Guernsey. Bodan just will get the penalty. Needs to just settle slow at the top on the shot. Third time, and offloads that to Robert, who will take the penalty. So not able to convert there. Guernsey still with the 7-goal margin as the Isle of Man look to goal. So the goal attack there, Philbin will leave the court. So the Isle of Man will restart on the whistle. So better goals, that's what the Isle of Man was searching for. Their centre pass as the clock counts down. So need to be quick to look into goal. There we see that's the end of the third quarter. Guernsey 26 goals to the Isle of Man men 20. So an interesting third quarter. Some changes maintaining the scoreline though were Guernsey. We'll be back in a few minutes' time to see the all important final 15 minutes of this game. We'll be right back. So welcome back for the final quarter. Guernsey men taking the lead at the moment in this game as the Isle of Man just make their way onto court. Just one change from Guernsey to report at the moment. Dan Bisson goes on at wing defence and replaces Tom Nifton. So, two players on the deck there. So, Abbott's back on his feet and Corrin. Looks like this will be a wiping of the floor. In, takes the shot, scores the goal. 7 goals, the difference. So the Isle of Man responds. Still a 6-goal margin. Guernsey looking strong with the work of James Robert, the goal attack, back in possession again. Steps to one side, sets the position. So not able to get that ball through, held ball, so Guernsey with Querapel, look long. Robert again in on the action. Bodan looks to position in the circle. So Abbott and Mason in a close contest there at centre. So, chance for the Isle of Man. Another goal on the board, still can't get less than 6, the Isle of Man, so this margin staying alive for Guernsey. Bodan out of the circle, both shooters out. Robert looking for an option, nothing available, so the Isle of Man again forced the turnover. Patient build-up by Guernsey, playing the short game in the goal third. Robert sights the defence again. Cool and composed, taking the shots there. He's the big threat to the Isle of Man. Surprised the Isle of Man have not put some kind of double or just put a bit more pressure on Robert just to try and restrict the movement and stop that constant scoring. So Guernsey go again through the midcourt. Corrin and Mulhern support the play. The Isle of Man transition again. Purple again, just not able to pull that ball in, gets the tip. Change being made at goal shooter for the Isle of Man. So the Isle of Man get a chance, win back possession. Clock's ticking, there is still a 7-goal deficit. The play from the Isle of Man, great shooting. Torrin Jones, who's entered the court for the Isle of Man at goal shooter, and Josem goes to the bench. Robert down, offloads that ball, he's back on his feet. Bodan puts the ball safely away. 31 goals Guernsey, 24 to the Isle of Man. Quirapal, superb elevation above the shot. An obstruction call, possession back with the Isle of Man. To the Isle of Man. Oh. So Guernsey look to extend the lead. Great ball into the back space there to Robert. Gets the ball back. Some pressure in there, the contest, the one-on-one, and that goes again to Hogan. Great rebound, chance for the Isle of Man just to sink another goal. Clever goal, not able to disrupt that shot as the Isle of Man put their score to 26, Guernsey 31. Again, the pressure, the strong arms over from the Guernsey defence. Robert right up the top, needs to transition back. There he goes. Mason keeps the ball in play, not in hands of the Iron Man players. And again, Mason rewarded. Paul in on the action again. Isle of Man get the rebound. So, 4-goal difference. Isle of Man on the comeback. The clock is going against them as we approach the 3-minute mark. 3 minutes to go, final quarter. Robert takes the ball in the back space, secures another goal for Guernsey. Just late takeoff there, so footwork call on Mason. So, 6-goal margin. This rematch will take place tomorrow. I'm sure lots of reflecting, lots of learning from the Isle of Man, particularly as they did go into the lead in the first quarter. But Guernsey just found their form with the work of Robert, particularly a strength for them in the goal attack position. So approaching the final minute, Guernsey moving through the court, certainly taking the pace off the ball there, but a cross court ball, trying to get that ball to Robert, was picked off, so they're just looking to get another goal on the board. So Guernsey, patient build-up, not in any rush to go anywhere, just moving the ball around, running the clock down, look long, find Robert. Hogan will get the shot, good throw. So, still time to score, ball with Robert. And there we go, super goal to finish. Probably the last goal of the game. There we go, that's the end of the match. The crowd entertainer, certainly everyone enjoyed that match as we see the final score. Guernsey men 34, Isle of Man men 27. And both squads will get the chance to compete again tomorrow. I'm sure we'll see some different combinations out on court, lots of learning. And I'm sure the Isle of Man will be seeking their revenge tomorrow in this game. So, Guernsey men versus the Isle of Man men will play again at 11. So, many thanks. We're leaving commentary and passing down to courtside. We'll be back tomorrow for the final day of the Island Games.
Experience an island like no other. The Isle of Man, the extraordinary story. Book now.
Well, welcome to the Isle of Man and a very special event, the first of the Invitational Island Netball matches.
Playing against teams of this standard is something we don't get to do very often, being from an island community. And even watching some of the matches that's going to be coming up this week is going to be amazing experience.
The first time that we've been involved in anything of the scale as well. Just the exposure for all our players is really good.
We've got 15 players with us and we have youth and experience. We're hoping to use everybody throughout the week.
We've had a look at some of the teams. We know the Isle of Man are 27th in the ranking at the moment, so know that they're going to be quite a tough team. Jersey and Guernsey have been a setter for quite a while now, and Orkney and Shetland as well are teams that we're looking to compete against.
Everyone says it's all fun and games, but you kind of want it to be serious. You want to go out with a few wins.
We're really lucky that we've got a really strong mix of players, that their combinations can be moved all around.
And for 5 days worth of netball, it's a lot to ask from them.
Absolutely. We know that those all 12 of the girls that are over with us are going to have to work their socks off. And for us, it's the first time we've done anything like this.
We know it's tournament netball and anything can happen. I'm going to have to earn every moment out there. But yeah, we'll be going for it for this week. We want to go out on top. Everyone's usually played everyone at some point and seen everyone at some point. That hasn't happened this time round. So there is a lot of unknown.
There's a much bigger picture at play here, and it's about not just representing your island, but representing netball at this competition and in the Island Games. And I think going forward, that's something that we all share, a common goal.
It's a great feeling playing for Orkney, and we've not really done anything outside of Scotland. And all we really have is our inter-county match against Shetland every year and the Scottish Cup that we enter.
I think for us, it's just seeing what we've done. Have we prepared in the way that we should prepare?
Yep.
Or do we need to go back and reflect and see where we need to go for there?
We've hosted a few competitions like this now, but the nerves are still there and we still want to do well for a home crowd. So although we're experienced, we still get the same adrenaline. And that's what this makes this competition quite exciting. It's nice to play new opponents and it's nice to play people that haven't played us before. So we're really looking forward to it. This has been all over social media. There's been a lot of excitement around it, and I think netball fans on the island are looking forward to this as well.
Probably just like to take a moment just to thank the Isle of Man Netball really for taking a leap of faith and backing the teams, backing the game and getting ourselves in a position where we can run something like this.
Well, congratulations, James Roberts. Guernsey taking the win there. My goodness, what a match that was.
That was really intense, really intense. We knew they were going to be so much better than when we played them a few years ago, but we weren't expecting that. That was really good. They've come on so much. It was really, really good to play in that game.
I'm sure they'd be delighted to hear that. You guys were behind in Q1?
Yeah. We tend to start slow as a team, but I didn't think we'd start that slow. but you've got to give credit to them, to the Isle of Man. They came out. They really flustered us for the first quarter. We were just like, what is going on? Yeah. It took us a while to get back in our groove, but yeah.
And some excellent shooting by yourself, James. You were hardly missing a goal there.
Yeah, well, you know, you've got to do what you've got to do to try and get the win, haven't you? So.
And then Luke Voden went off, slightly rattled the team, made adjustments?
No, not rattled the team. We were good. He got a knock in the back, really quite painful.
Ouch.
And I think, few emotions there, but he's fine. He came back on, cooler heads.
And then you extended your lead further with some really great defending by Tristan and Luke in the defence area.
They started off a bit sluggish, and we had a bit of a bit of a chat to them at the first quarter, but they were epic. And Tristan with his jump is just it's a special
it
weapon.
It was phenomenal to watch. But that there, no changes. The team was happy. Tomorrow, 11 p.m. or a.m. All go again.
Yes, absolutely. We're buzzing for it. There might be some of us older ones who might take a step back. We might be aching in the morning.
So that's it, recovery and preparation tonight.
Yeah, in the casino. I mean, I didn't say that.
Well, anyway, congratulations, James. Yeah, good luck for tomorrow. Cheers. Thank you. And now we'll catch up with Torren Jones from the Isle of Man side. Well, Torren, how was that?
It was exciting. It was quite intense because I've never played the time we first played Guernsey. And so like the first time I played them, it's quite a different competition to playing the people we play on the Isle of Man.
Yeah, it seemed very, very competitive. There was lots of turnovers made by the Isle of Man.
Yeah, there's great hustle from quite a lot of the boys in the midcourt. Everyone just energetic, excited to play Guernsey again after quite a few of them played the first time, so coming back and trying again.
Well, that was it, leading in Q1 by 4 goals. You must have been well on target.
Yeah, everyone was well excited after that first quarter. Came out like guns blazing, everyone excited. And then we're unlucky to like lose, but we'll go again tomorrow.
And what about this crowd that were behind you tonight?
All energetic, all the girls like supporting, screaming, especially when I came on, I saw my first one. They were just screaming. It was well loud. It was great to have them.
It really was. And how was it for you to represent the Isle of Man in basically one of the first competitive men's matches?
Oh, it was great. I love it. Every time I play for the men in just the league, it's great. But then playing in front of an audience as well, and then against like, in an international level, is great.
Yeah, and tomorrow you're up again, 11 a.m. I keep saying 11 p.m. 11 a.m. Well, lots of prep tonight and recovery.
Yeah, just resting and make sure I sleep well.
Yeah. Well, congratulations anyway, and we'll be back tomorrow. Okay, thanks, Torren.
Thank you.
So that's us for today. What a great evening it's been. The men really did put on something special, so exciting. And they'll be back, like I say, at 11 a.m. tomorrow. We've got a great schedule ahead. 9 a.m. start, so earlier on our final day, Innismon against Guernsey. The Isle of Man men's and Guernsey men's back again at 11 a.m., like I say. And then the Scottish Islands at 1 p.m., Orkney versus Shetland. And then two at the top of the table, the hosts, the Isle of Man and Jersey at 3 p.m. Games not to be missed. We'll see you then.